Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Krishan Dupain, a first year master student of Data Science and Quality Management Science in Indian Statistical Institute. And this is the first video of the MSQMS previous year question solving playlist. This question paper is of 2015, this QMA paper 2015. You may see the questions here. And in this video I will solve the first 10 problems. So let's begin. The first question, the values of x, y, z are given with p not equal to q not equal to r. We have to get the value of this term. So we can write here yz plus zx plus xy. The values of x, y, z are given. So I am writing this together. I am adding those three terms. Here we will get, try to solve the above term. Take r common from first two terms, q square minus qr plus rp minus p square, let's write pq here, p minus q, r minus p, p minus q, q minus r. So here you can get that if you take r common, it will be p minus q minus p square minus q square, q p minus q. Take p minus q common from this term and this term, so you can write p minus q here, so you will get r into r minus p minus q plus pq. You can get p minus q if you multiply this and write rp minus qr plus pq. If you see here, you can write this term as r minus q into r minus p divided by r minus p, p minus q, q minus r, which implies minus 1. So the first question, answer of the first question is this option C, minus 1. I am erasing this solution, so if you have not done yet, please do it right now, pause the video and I will erase before going to question number 2. Question number 2. The value of u is given, u equal to tan inverse x by y. We have to get the value of del 2 u del x 2 plus del 2 u del y 2 plus del 2 u del z 2. Now here there is no element for z, so we can ignore that. So basically we have to find del 2 u del x 2 plus del 2 u del y 2. Now u is given, u is a function of x and y. The first differentiate with respect to x partially, we will get del u del x equal to 1 by 1 plus x square divided by y square into 1 by y, which gives us x square plus y square, y by x square plus y square. Similarly, differentiate partially with respect to y, we get 1 by 1 plus x square plus y square into, if we differentiate it with respect to y, we will get minus x divided by y square. So we will get minus x divided by x square plus y square. Again, differentiate this del u del x part with respect to x, then we will get del u del 2 u del x 2 equal to y into x square plus y square whole power 2. There will be a minus sign and into 2x. Similarly, if we differentiate this del u del y term with respect to y, partially we'll get x square plus y square whole square. There is a minus, so there will be plus x into 2y. So these two terms are same, but their signs are opposite. So if we add them, we'll get del 2u del x2 plus del 2u del y2 equal to 0. So the option will be 2b, 2b side. Question number 3. We have to get the value of this integration xy dx dy for this over the region A, where is the domain bounded by x axis, ordinate x equal to 2 and curve x square equal to 4y, which is a parabola. So let's first draw this x square equal to 4y. So this will be like this, x equal to 2a, x equal to 2a, and this point it is a to a. So the area is this area. This is the area A. We have to find the value of this integration I over this area. So we can write like this way, I equal to x will vary from 0 to 2a, x, y will vary from 0 to x square by 4a, as this curve is x square equal to 4ay, y dy, can write dx. So we'll get x equal to 0 to 2a, x, this is y square by 2, 0 to x square by 4a dx. We'll get x equal to 0 to 2a, x into by 2 here, x to the power 4 divided by 16 square dx. So 1 by 32 square here, and this is x to the power 5. So after integration, it would be x to the power 6 by 6, 0 to 2a, 1 by 32 square into 2 to the power 6, 64. A to the power 6 by 6. So if we, it will be 2, 3 square, it a to the power 4 divided by 3. This is the answer, option B. Question number 4. We have to find this integration I equal to dx by x plus x log x. You can write this by this. So take z equal to 1 plus log x. If you differentiate it, it will get dx by x. So dx by x is given here, so we can write dz by 1 plus log x, I mean z. So this integral will be log of mod z plus c. We know z is 1 plus log x. Let's see, it was very easy. The option is log of 1 plus log x. Let's consider option D. Question number 5. There is a series given. We have to take the sum of this series. So we can write this like this way. 3 minus 1 by 3 factorial. 5 minus 1 by 5 factorial. Plus 7 minus 1 by 7 factorial, like this way. So we are getting 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial, 1 by 4 factorial minus 1 by 5 factorial, like this way. You know the series of e to the power x. It is summation x to the power I divided by I factorial, where the value of I is 0 to infinity. If we put x equal to minus 1, this series will be like 2 to the power minus 1 equal to I equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 to the power I by divided by I factorial. That means into it will be 1 minus 1 plus 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial plus 1 by 4 factorial minus 1 by 5 factorial, which implies 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial. This thing is same with this. So actually the answer of this problem is equal to e to the power minus 1. Option D. The correct answer is option D. Question number 6. The sales of a firm is promoted by advertisement campaign according to the rule. There is a rule given that TSDT equal to 100 e to the power minus 0.25 t, where S denotes the sales and T is the number of years since the close of the campaign. That means S5 means that the total sales till 5 years. So we have to calculate the sales promoted during the 5th year. So if we do this like this, S5 minus S4, that means total sales till 5th year and total sales till 4th year. It will subtract the total sales till 4th year from the total sales till 5th year, we will get the sales promoted during the 5th year. So we have to calculate this S5 minus S4. DS equal to 100 into e to the power minus 0.25 t. If we now integrate this, we will get S, that sales is equal to 100 to the power minus 0.25 t divided by minus 0.25 plus some constant C, which will be minus 400 e to the power minus 0.25 t plus C. Now this S, this is ST, that means that the total sales till the TTH year. Okay, we have to calculate S5 minus S4. So we will get minus 400 e to the power minus 1.25 plus 400 e to the power minus 1. This equals to 32.56. So the sales promoted during the 5th year is 32.56 millions of rupees. This is the answer. Question number 7. The Indian cricket team consists of 16 players, total 16 players. Among them, 2 are wicket keepers, 5 are bowlers, and their remaining 9 are batsmen. A cricket team is to be chosen of the team of 11. We have to select 1 wicket keeper and at least 4 bowlers. So we have 2 types of combination, that means 1 wicket keeper, 4 bowlers and 6 batsmen. This is one combination. The other one is 1 wicket keeper, the total 5 bowlers, to all the 5 bowlers and 5 batsmen. From 2 wicket keeper to choose 1 into, from 5 bowlers we have to choose 4 into, from 9 batsmen we have to choose 6. This equals 840. From 2 wicket keeper to choose 1 into, from 5 bowlers we have to choose 5 into, from 9 batsmen we have to choose 5. This equals 252. So total 1092. Option D is the right. Question number 8. A determinant is given. A, B, C, A square, B square, C square, A cube minus 1, B cube minus 1, C cube minus 1, which equal to 0. You may know that for a column or for a row, the determinant behaves like a linear function. That means you can write this determinant as this. माइनस ए बी सी ए स्क्वायर बी स्क्वायर सी स्क्वायर वन वन वन। ओके इफ यू टेक कॉमन ए बी सी, आई एम टेकिंग कॉमन ए फ्रॉम फर्स्ट रो बी फ्रॉम सेकेंड रो सी फ्रॉम थर्ड रो, यू विल गेट वन ए स्क्वायर वन बी बी स्क्वायर वन सी सी स्क्वायर माइनस। इफ वी इंटरचेंज द फर्स्ट रो एंड थर्ड रो एंड देन द सेकेंड रो एंड थर्ड रो, वी विल गेट द सेम मैट्रिक्स हियर ए बी सी ए स्क्वायर बी स्क्वायर सी स्क्वायर। एज देर आर टू इंटरचेंजेस तो सो द साइन विल बी सेम, वी विल गेट यू बी सी माइनस वन इंटू दिस मैट्रिक्स वन ए स्क्वायर वन बी बी स्क्वायर वन सी सी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू जीरो। फॉर दिस डिटर्मिनेंट टर्म वी कैन एक्सपेंड इट लाइक दिस वे, जीरो ए माइनस बी स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर जीरो बी माइनस सी बी स्क्वायर माइनस सी स्क्वायर वन सी सी स्क्वायर। वॉट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम जस्ट डूइंग आर वन माइनस आर टू एंड आर टू सॉरी टू माइनस आर थ्री, दैट्स इट। वी आर टेकिंग कॉमन ए माइनस बी बी माइनस सी if we expand this determinant with respect to this first column then b plus c minus a plus b that is c minus a equal to 0. Now in the question it is given that a b c are all different, so this is not equal to 0, this is not equal to 0, this is not equal to 0. So we have to have ABC minus 1 equal to 0. This means ABC equal to 1. This is the question, what is the value of ABC? So the value of ABC is 1, which is option B. Now question number 9. The product of the first 100 positive integer ends with what? So the number of zeros at the end of any number is determined by the fact that how many tens are there in that number. The 10 means 10 is the product of two prime numbers 2 and 5. Now if we find that how many 2s are there in a number from 1 to 100, then that will take a lot of time. So we'll check that how many 5s, how many factor 5 are there in the numbers from 1 to 100. So we have to check the number of numbers having at least one factor 5, and we have to check the number of numbers having at least two factor 5. I'm not going for 5 cube, that 3 factor, because that is 125, which is greater than 100. We have to find the first for the first 100 positive integers factor the product of first 100 positive integers. So I am not checking this, I am checking this only. So the number of numbers having at least one factor 5, that is the which numbers 5 10 15 dot 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 100, how many numbers are there? 20 numbers. Similarly, number of numbers having at least 2 factor 5. How many numbers? 4 numbers. 25, 50, 75 and 100. 4 numbers. So total number of factor 5 in 100 factorial is 20 plus 4, 24. So there are a total 24 zeros at the end of the product of the first 100 positive integers. The answer is option D. Question number 10. A function fx is given, mod x plus sin x plus cos cube x. We first check the continuity. Limit x tending at x equal to 0 point, we will check the continuity. X equal to 0 plus fx. This implies this function will be x plus sin x plus cos cube x. So this will be 0 plus 0 plus 1 equal to 1. Similarly, limit x tending to 0 minus fx equal to limit x tending to 0 minus, this is minus x plus sin x plus cos cube x. This implies 0 plus 0 plus 1, which implies 1. So limit x tending to 0 plus fx, this implies limit x tending to 0 minus fx, which is implied to f0. Then f is continuous. Now we have to check the differentiability. If f is differentiable, then f dash x equal to mod x by x plus cos x minus 3 cos square x into sin x. Limit x tending to 0 plus f dash x, this will be limit x tending to 0 plus x by a plus cos x minus 3 cos square x sin x, which implies 1 plus 1 minus 0 is implies 2. Limit x tending to 0 minus fx f dash x, x tending to 0 minus minus x by x plus cos x minus 3 cos square x sin x, which implies minus 1 plus 1 minus 0 is implies 0. So limit x tending to 0 plus fx f dash x, sorry, not equal to limit x tending to 0 minus f dash x. So f is not differentiable at x equal to 0. So we are getting the correct option as option A. We are not doing this option D, as for a continuous function at x equal to 0, it is automatically a bounded function. So the option A will be correct choice. So thank you. In the next video, we will do the next 10 problems. At first you try yourself and then come back to watch this video. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.